Shalom. First and foremost, we want to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Double honors to the apostles of the Great Millstone. And a sincere greeting to all the Akim that are making the calling and election sure. And in this lesson, you know, to the power and the spirit, we want to go into death shall be swallowed up in victory. I'll bring it up. In Isaiah?
Yeah, Isaiah. No, that one first. And then all right.
This is 1 Corinthians 15 and 54. It says, so when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption.
Yeah. And that incorruption, man, is talking about when Yahweh Bashim Yahshai changes brothers' bodies, man. Basically, you know, spiritual power too. You know, because when in the time that's coming with the FEMA troops and stuff, you know, and all the chaos in America that's about to happen, the Lord's going to bless his men with spiritual power, you know? And ultimately, when we get in those chariots, man, our bodies are gonna be changed into those, what do you call them? What's it called? We're down here, these bodies are called, in the scriptures.
It's called, what is it? Terrestrial.
Super celestial? It's not super terrestrial.
Super terrestrial.
We're going to get changed into super terrestrial bodies, so to speak. You know, we basically going to be a Superman.
God.
You know? That's the uncorrupt, that's the corruptible turning in uncorruptible. You know? Because Yahweh Bashim Yahshai, when he comes back, and Lord willing, we are the man of the Lord, and I speak for brothers out there first, man, before myself, you know? From the elders of GMS on down, man, to the true, the brothers teaching the word in truth and sincerity, our bodies are going to be changed. Go ahead, brother.
It says, and this mortal shall have put on immortality.
Yeah, because what? We're mortal right now. The scriptures say we are gods, but we shall die like men. You know, so we're basically in a fleshly sense, we're mortal, you know, because what, you know, that because we can get sick, you know, we die first and foremost, you know what I mean, viruses, we're susceptible to different viruses and stuff. These bodies that we got in Esau society are weak, frail. This the lowest state we've been in, you know, since the world was created, you know. Or the heavens, the world, all that. It's the lowest estate we've been in. We're not like our ancient days, man. You know, like in the time of David, when we were actually mighty and stuff like that. You know, when we went against these heathens, man, and we put them to flight. You know, but we in the so-called white man's society, America, and this devil does what? He puts GMO in our food. You know, he puts poisons in the air to kill off our immune system, to make us sick, to make us weak. So we're corruptible, man. You know, we're mortal. Go ahead, baby.
Come. It says, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory.
And the brothers, can you get that in Isaiah?
Isaiah 5:8.
Yeah, death shall be swallowed up in victory. So even in the New Testament, they always did what? Quoted from the Old Testament. And we're going to get the account that was quoted. You know? Death shall be swallowed up in victory. Because at that time, when the time comes, Yahweh Bashim Yahshua is going to bless brothers. And these Edomites out here, man, and these FEMA troops and stuff, they ain't going to be able to do us no harm. You know? So that time is coming. It's coming real soon. As you see, World War III is about to spark off. You know, these super high elites and stuff are digging holes into the earth to hide from who? Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, because they know he's damn near coming. The scriptures say, man, in the midst of World War III, you know what I'm saying? It doesn't actually say it, but it gives you an exact example of how Yahweh Shai is going to come back, and that's in the midst of World War III.
Okay.
And these elites see that World War III is popping off, and they're what? They're so afraid. They see brothers waking up to the truth day in and day out. They seeing that we getting our name back.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We got the name of Yahweh Bashim Yahshai back. You know, and the scriptures say what, man? The name of the Heavenly Father is dreadful amongst the heathen.
That's right.
So they're scared. That's why they're going to hide. You know?
Hey, if I may say something too, you know, you know, I find it kind of interesting that, you know, the movies that they make, you know, especially the movies and the TV series, you know, they got that new series. It's talking about King David. It's talking about the book of Samuel, of Kings. I believe it's called Of Kings or something, of Prophets and Kings, something like that. But anyways, it escapes me. But, you know, they're talking about King David, and you know, they put that spin on it, you know, that he looked like they were Edomites, a so-called white man, you know what I mean? And in the movies like X-Men and The Fifth Wave and all these other movies in the past, like, 2012, you know what I'm saying, Apocalypto, all these movies that are coming out in this last decade, you know what I mean, they're bringing them out because it's like they got some type of admiration for Israelites. Like, they want to be, you know what I'm saying? They wish they could be like us because, you know, the scripture said they didn't receive the promise. You know what I'm saying? And they know they're going down. So they're bringing this truth out, you know what I mean? Because they're devils and they can't tell you straight up because, you know, they hid this from us. So, you know, they want to put it out there so that, you know, the people don't run in mass hysteria and they're not all in blindness. You know what I'm saying? So they give out a little bit of truth here and there. Like, they throw you a bone, you know what I'm saying? And only some people, you know what I mean, we'll pick it up. That's why some, you know, us that are in the truth, we flock to the movies and we pick out, you know what I mean, the truth from that. And they know that the spiritual power is coming because they make movies like, what is it, that the new X-Men, you know what I'm saying? And
the Marvel Comics.
Yeah, the Marvel Comics and all that is because they know who we are. And they know that, you know, that we're going to get the spiritual power, Lord willing, and you know what I'm saying, we're the elect. But, you know, they know that we have that ability and the Most High is going to be able to give that to us. And they know that they're going down, and they know that these bodies are going to be transformed, and they know that we're going to come back, you know, Lord willing, and we're going to destroy them. You know what I'm saying? So they know, man, you know. But I'm going to go ahead and get this. It's Isaiah 25 and 8. It says, "He will swallow up death in victory, and the Lord power will wipe away tears from all faces."
That's right. It says he will swallow up death in victory, and the Most High will wipe away all tears from faces. Because when you read the book of Revelations, you know, Yahweh Shem Yahshua basically said, man, he's going to wipe away Israel's tears, man. You know what I'm saying? He's going to wipe away our tears. Can you get that in there?
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
I think it's Revelation, the 17th chapter, I want to say.
And then after that, can you get the fame in the land that we will put to shame?
Yeah.
Zechariah 3 and 19. Yeah, because Yahweh Shem Yahshua said, he was going to wipe away the tears from Israel's face. You know, mainly starting with the elect, first and foremost. I gotta put that out there because two-thirds ain't going to get this, man. All right? Two-thirds ain't going to get it. So, Yahweh Shem Yahshua is going to do what? He's going to wipe away tears from our face because we're going through all this hell in this society. You know, we've been oppressed by the so-called white man for what? Going on 500 years? You know, we're still in captivity to this day. You know, we go through shit in our daily lives, you know, that only Yahweh Shem Yahshua can give us the comforter to comfort us through it until he comes and does what? Wipe away all our tears from our face. Meaning we're not going to be in hell no more, all right, when the kingdom comes.
So like, it's a Revelation 21 and 4. It says, "And the Most High shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall be any more pain, for the former things are passed away."
That's right. The former things are passed away. What? This wicked society, these vile ass bodies. You know, what else? Wickedness in a whole, because right. America is what? It's the highest place of wickedness. They do what over here? They practice witchcraft. Mm-hmm. They oppress the Israelites. This America is the main place where the Israelites are. You know, this is where the main deliverance is gonna be. But can you read that over again?
Con. This Revelation 21 and 4. It says, "And the Most High shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death."
No more death.
Neither sorrow.
Sorrow.
Nor crying.
Nor crying. Because we, like I said, we in hell in this society. And it's there's a saying, it's much harder to be righteous or to do right than it is to be wicked. So for the brother that's actually trying through sincerity of Yahweh Shem Yahshua to be right, You know, in this wicked society, man, you know, it's a sorrowful thing, man, to not even be able to completely be right. You know, to still be able to go off. That's why our bodies are gonna have to be changed.
Okay.
You know.
Yeah. Even Paul said it in the book of Romans. He said, "Who will save me from this vile body?" You know what I mean? Because, you know what I mean. In this body, the spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. And when you're at work, or when you're at a, you know what? Just a matter of fact, today I met this dude. He said he was a Christian. You know what I mean? And the guys at work, they give him hell. You know what I'm saying? And today, through the spirit, he said, "Hey, because some of the guys at work, they have asked me certain things, and they, you know, with conversations come up through the spirit. I have talked about the truth. So, you know, it's God around at work about, you know, that I speak about the truth, I speak about the Most High, and, you know, and Yahweh Shai, you know what I mean? And that dude, he catches a lot of hell, man. And they make fun of him. They talk about his, behind his back and stuff like that. They make jokes about him. And he's going through hell, man. He goes through hell. And when he comes and talks to me, man, it's like, you know, I just barely met the dude today. But I've been hearing a lot about him. So this dude, you know what I'm saying? He's probably wishing to get up out of here because he doesn't know the truth exactly, but he believes in the Messiah. So, you know, a lot of our people are wishing to get up out of here, man, because they know that it's death up in here, man, because we go to work day in and day out, you know what I mean? Barely making enough from the week to take our people out, take our family out, you know what I mean? So, you know, and, you know, Jake's is dying on the news everywhere. You know, so in reality, we're not at rest here, man, and we're yearning to get up out of here, man. We're suffering right now. This is a time of suffering. You know what I mean? And so, you know, so the Lord's gonna come back, and there's gonna be no more death because, you know, Lord willing, if we make it into them chariots, man, in the blink of an eye, we ain't gonna be the same anymore. We ain't gonna look at things the same. There's gonna be no more suffering. You know what I'm saying? And death, the scripture said that we shall be immortal, so we're never gonna die. So, you know, you want me to go back and finish that in Isaiah?
Yeah.
It says, back in Isaiah 25:8, I'm going to read it again. It says, "He will swallow up death in victory, and the Lord's power will wipe away tears from all faces."
Yeah. Yeah, we're going to swallow up death in victory. Because when the kingdom comes, in the kingdom, you know, we're going to live for a period of 1,000 years. You know, then our body's gonna do what? Transition to another body, or however that Yahweh Shem HaShem is gonna have it happen, because our lifespan is supposed to be an age, which is 1,000 years. You know, it's not supposed to look. And in another form of death, man, we die at what? Some people fucking die before 70, 80 years old. But to even be living in America for that long, that's fucking hell, man.
Yeah.
That's why by the age of like 80 or 90, man, you got stuck up ass motherfuckers, man.
Yeah.
Because they've been living in this society for that long amount of years, and they're going through hell and shit. They don't want to hear what the fuck anybody has to say. I don't care if you could be 90 years old, and there's some people that just take it for what it is, but you can see the bitterness of some old people. You can see it. It pours out of their soul. The old grumpy Jake or person that's in the fucking store just complaining about everything because through the period of the time that they were living on the earth, they've been through a lot of hell.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. You know, our people, you know, they talk about how things used to be, yeah, how good things were. You know what I mean? And you know, you hear a lot of Jake, you know, they're ready to die. You know what I mean? They see what's going on, and the spirit yearns for a better place. Because when we tell this truth to a lot of people, they get that remembrance, and they wake up, and they know this is not their place. And a lot of them say, when you tell them the truth, they, well, you know, if I have to die, then I'm going to die. You know what I mean? So the Lord said he'll have mercy on whom he will have mercy, compassion. So, you know, man, they could be some of them Jakes, they could make it, you know what I mean? Because they know, they see through the lies. You know what I'm saying? And they were truth seekers in somehow, some way, you know, and all being part of the body. You know, and all Israel, you know, ultimately being part of the body, but that elect, man, they're gonna see through the lies, they're gonna see through this BS, you know, and that's what it really comes down to.
I got a scripture. This is 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17. "For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory, while we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not which are not seen are eternal. You know what I mean? So, hey, for our light affliction is but for a moment. So all the hell that we catching, I mean, it's just but for a moment. Because we looking forward to what? The kingdom of heaven. You know, we want to be worthy in the sight of Yahweh Bashim Yahshai, the Lord willing to obtain that. You know, because the scriptures say that Yahweh Shah was made perfect through what? Sufferings. Mm-hmm. So suffering ain't always a bad thing. You know, through sufferings, man, you know, and that word suffering also means patience.
Yeah.
You know, waiting for Yahweh Bashim Yahshai to come. So, and Yahweh Bashim Yahshai said what, man? He said, ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. You know, ain't no servant greater than his master. And he also said, you know, if when you come into this truth, to bear up your cross.
God.
So, I mean, we're going to suffer, you know?
Oh, yeah. Oh, let me finish this, and I got another precept. So, it says in Isaiah 25 and 8, it says, I'm just going to read it so we can move along. It says, he will swallow up death in victory, and the Lord's power will wipe away tears from all faces, and the rebuke of his people shall he take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken it.
Right.
Okay, so you know, Yahweh Hashem Yahushua is going to take the rebuke. You know, I mean, the captivity that we went through, that the other nations are really just looking at us like, you know, those dudes ain't, you know what I'm saying? They're nothing but a bunch of, you know, low lives and that name they put upon us. You know what I mean? That bad cloud. You know what I mean? So the Lord's going to take away all that. But I got a precept right here in Hosea 13 and 14 that says, I will ransom them from the power of the grave. I will redeem them from death. Mm. O death, I will be thy plagues. O grave, I will be thy destruction. God. Repentance shall be hid from my eyes. You know, so basically, Yahweh Hashem Yahshua is going to take death and like put it in the bag, man. You know what I'm saying? We ain't going to see it anymore, you know, Lord willing. But, you know, so, you know, where's the plagues? Where's all the suffering and all that? Like, we ain't gonna suffer no more, and that should be comforting, you know, to the Hakim, that, you know, that the Lord's gonna take all these things that we see, you know, because we see it, you know, we go through it, we suffer, you know, we wake up every day and we're like, you know, knowing this truth, you know, we know we gotta go and make, you know, pennies, basically, you know what I'm saying, and you know, the scriptures say a coward dies a thousand deaths. But on the other coin to that, you know, at the same token, you know, us being in the truth, man, when someone gets crazy with you or the boss, that, you know, they don't want to give you your promotion and you know, going to hell with family, they don't want to speak to you no more like that. You know, we die too, man. You know, like we're dead to the world. You know what I'm saying? Oh, there's scripture on that too.
I mean, yeah, come on. Yeah, and when it says the Most High shall put death in a grave, because at one point too, we didn't have the truth. So we were considered as what? Dead. That's why the scriptures say in Revelations 11 and 8, what? Their dead bodies shall lie in the streets of Sodom and Egypt. Man. It's not talking about actual dead bodies. It's talking about spiritually dead. Because when you look around, you know, from many, only few brothers got the truth. You don't have a camp, a congregation like these churches out here. You don't have a whole church full of, or a whole camp full of, 1,200 people. You don't have that because Yahweh Bashim Yahshua said what? Let me get this for you.
Come.
I'm gonna bring it up. You know. Cause Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, he doesn't deal with the masses. I'm gonna bring it up.
That's right. You know, so yet, you know, even in the book of Romans, it says we are counted all the day long for the slaughter. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, because these wicked elites, man, you know, they want to get rid of, they want to ultimately chip the whole world with the RFID microchip is the mark of the beast, and they want to chip the whole world to get rid of all Israel. You know what I'm saying? Because they know there's a confusion of faces, so they want to get rid of that royal bloodline. So, you know, in the midst of that, they're going to throw even Edomites, you know what I'm saying, which could be Jake. But everybody ultimately is going to get that, you know, they're going to want to chip them up. You know what I mean? Because they're trying to get rid of that royal bloodline. They're trying to kill everybody, you know what I mean? Because they hate Israel, you know what I mean?
This is Ezekiel chapter 11, verse 16. Therefore, say, thus said the Lord power, although I have cast them far off among the heathen, and although I have scattered them among the countries, because what? Israel is what? Scattered amongst the four corners of the earth. You have some Israelites that grew up not knowing they were Israelites in the heathen customs. You know? It's the same time in the, it's the same thing back in the book of Acts. You had Israelites that grew up not knowing they were Israelites. That's why they called them Gentiles, because they were in a Gentile state of mind. They grew up with heathen customs. But when the apostles came to them, what happened? He told them they were Israelites, and now they did what? They knew that they were Israelites. They weren't calling themselves Negroes or stuff like that, because that's a Gentile state of mind. You know, same thing with us, brothers. You know, we were once Gentiles in the flesh that grew up what? Not knowing that we were Israelites. So we were calling ourselves Negroes, African, Black, African Americans. Then Yahweh Bashem Yahshua had it to where we woke up and now we're calling ourselves back to who we are, Israelites. So we're no longer what? Gentiles. We're calling ourselves Israel again. You know? And it says, yet will I be to them as a little sanctuary in the countries where they shall come. A little sanctuary, and that's the elect. You know? Many are called, but few are chosen. So Yahweh Bashim Yahshua doesn't deal with the masses. You know, he doesn't deal with the mass amount of peoples. You gotta realize it, man. King David was what? You know? He wasn't, as an appearance, the strongest looking person. You know what I'm saying? Who did Samuel go to first? You know, he went to Jesse, and then Jesse said, look, this son right here, he's strong and this and that. No, you know what I mean? The Most High chose what? David, the one that didn't appear as his brother to be his king, to be the king, man. All right, so the Most High always deals with the underdogs, and just like he deals with a small amount of number, all right, and that's starting with the elect. He's gonna use a small group of people, and 144,000 is big. I can't lie to you. I've never seen myself in a crowd of 144,000 people, but Yahweh Bashim Yahshai, to him that's a small number. So the Most High is gonna use a small number of people. Israelites, the elect, to do what? To take down America. Alright? Because Yahweh Bashim Yahshua is going to use what? His men, his foot soldiers. Alright? And it says, therefore, thus saith the Lord Power, I will even gather you from the people and assemble you out of the countries where ye have been scattered, and I will give you the land of Israel. And that's plain. That's what Yahweh Bashim Yahshua is about to do right now. That's how why you see certain brothers in certain countries. Other countries waking up, calling themselves Israelites, because he's gathering through what? First the word, you know, the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahshua, all right? First the word, and then he's going to ultimately gather them through what? The chariots, you know?
Come on. Yeah. Let's see. Let me see, I got a precept right here. It says, it's Ephesians 5 and 14. It says, wherefore he saith, awake thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Yahweh Shai shall give thee light. Okay, you know, because, you know, basically, you know, when we were in that other lifestyle, when the Lord didn't open up our minds yet, when we were still in the world, you know what I mean? We were basically dead. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, in the Gentile state, like the brother was saying. So the Lord says, it says, awake thou that sleepest and arise from the dead, and Yahweh Shai shall give thee light. So, you know, we walk according to this truth so that we have light, because scripture says that they have no light in them. So roughly paraphrasing, so, you know, basically those that don't walk into this truth, you know what I'm saying? And the scripture also says those that wander out of the way of understanding shall remain in the congregation of the dead. You know what I'm saying? Because 2/3 of our nation, they don't hear the truth, you know what I mean? Because it's not for them, you know? So, you know, Yahweh Shai woke us up basically from a dead state, you know what I mean, and put us into the truth. We have the light, okay? So, you know, but when the Most High comes back, you know, even much more, You know what I mean? No more death. There's gonna be no. We're gonna get all the other secrets that he didn't give to us. You know. We're gonna get a full understanding. And he's gonna put the word in our inward part. He's gonna put the truth in our inward part. So we're gonna walk naturally righteous. You know what I mean? Not striving for righteousness like we are now. You know, we do all this to make a calling and election sure. You know, basically.
I got that for you right here, brother. This is Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 26. A new heart also will I give you, and a new spirit will I put within you. And I will take away the stony heart out of your flesh, and I will give you an heart of flesh. And I will put my spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes, and ye shall keep my judgments.
Come. That's right. You know, because... you know, that stony heart is like, you know, it's like the parable of the sower. You know, when the seed rolls in those stony places, it doesn't grow. You know what I'm saying? So, the Lord said He's gonna put that. You know, it's gonna be written in our hearts, which is meaning our minds. You know what I mean? So everything that we do is gonna be righteousness when He comes back. So that's what that scripture was talking about.
I got another one that went up with that. This is Ecclesiasticus chapter 17, verse 16. Every man from his youth is given to evil, neither could they make to themselves fleshly hearts for stony. You know? Because what? Like the brother was just going into, man, that stony heart, man. You know, meaning that heart that's made of stone, meaning we go off, you know? That's why Moses wrote the law, statutes, and commandments. How about Shimei Hashai wrote the law, statutes, and commandments on what? Stone tablets, you know? Because, the stony heart means we can go off. And the Most High knew that Israel has stony hearts. Because even when you read in the scriptures, in the time of Egypt, when you read the book of 1 Samuel, you know, through the first 10 chapters, what happened? They didn't, Yahweh Shem Yahshua said, look, to Samuel, like, yo, all this stuff I did for them, brought them out of the land of Egypt, man, and they want a king? They don't want me to rule over them? All right, I'm going to give it to them then, you know? But that was putting them in a place to where King David was gonna come in, you know, after King Saul. But Yahweh Shem Yahshua always gives you an example of backsliding Israel. They backslid when what? We were coming out of Egypt. They went to go back.
Yeah.
That's why it's backsliding Israel, yeah. Because
backsliding daughter.
Yeah. Come. How did Yahweh Shem Yahshua delivered you for His namesake out of the land of your captives? Or out of people that were oppressing you, did all those wonders, you know what I mean? And y'all scarcely made it. The Israelites, they scarcely were saved, you know, because they had what? Death following them when Yahweh Shem Yahshua had Moses part the Red Sea. And they had death what? Coming behind them. And they scarcely made it, you know? And Yahweh Shem Yahshua had what? The Egyptians get drowned. You know, but they scarcely made it, and they wanted to go back to oppression because they had what? Not faith in Yahweh Shem Yahshua, as in Hebrews the 11th chapter, because the scriptures say what? It is impossible to please the Heavenly Father without faith. So this is a faith thing, man. Even our everyday lives, you know, it's a faith thing in Yahweh Shem Yahshua that we're gonna be what? Delivered from certain things, you know, delivered from death, you know. Delivered from a nigga trying to shoot you or something like that. Yahweh Shem Yahshua gives us the wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. You know what I'm saying? First off, the wisdom to be able to deal with certain scenarios. And that's Yahweh Shem Yahshua delivering you from death too. Because you're using His words. That's why the scriptures say, wisdom and knowledge to be what? The stability of thy times. You know?
I got a precept talking about about death, but according to like how you know we were in the world and that was a dead state, but coming into the truth, you know, we're baptized with Yahweh Shai through in His death. It says Romans the 6th chapter, it says It says, 6:3, know ye not that so many of us as were baptized in Yahweh Shai were baptized unto his death? Therefore we are buried with him by baptism into death, that like as Yahweh Shai was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in a newness of life. Okay, so, you know, basically we're not supposed to walk the same, and the same things that we were doing, you know what I'm saying, and lend our members for unrighteousness. Okay, but and it goes on to say, for if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection. Okay, and in the likeness of his resurrection is that when basically Yahweh Shai died, okay, without spot, without blemish, without sin, and we're trying to walk the best that we can so that we're sinless with the Most High, and in a sense the Most High sees us as sinless, you know what I mean, because you know we are his servants and we're doing what he's telling us to do, but even more than that, we're supposed to be like when he comes back, you know what I mean, we're not gonna, you know, Lord willing, we don't taste death, but there'll be some that die, but they'll resurrect first. So when the resurrection, what it's talking about, it says shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection. So when he comes back, we also too are going to be like, you know, defeating death. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? So, you know, Lord willing, you know, we're the elect men, you know, some of us, we won't see death. All right. And there's another one. If you have something, go ahead.
Yeah. This is 1 John chapter 3. Verse 2, beloved, now are we the sons of the Most High, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Yeah, because like the brother was saying, man, when Yahweh Bashim Yahushan comes back, you know, the scripture just said it, man. It says, but we know that when he shall appear, meaning when he appears in the heavens, breaks through the firmament, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Because in the book of Isaiah, what does it say? He said, I would not meet thee as a man. So when Yahweh Bashim Yahshan comes back, it says what? We shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. He's coming back as a what? A supernatural being, man.
Yeah.
You know, he's coming back as a brute force. So Yahweh Bashim Yahshan, and that goes into what the brother was, you know, what we were talking about first. Death shall be swallowed up in victory. When our bodies get changed, because when Yahweh Bashim Yahshan comes back, then it's going to be known who are the sons of the Heavenly Father, the true sons, all right? Because this world doesn't see us right now as the children of Yahweh Bashim Yahshan, you know, the children of Israel, which he is a prince of Yahweh, man, or he is a prince of the power. They don't see us as that. So when the Lord breaks through the firmament, you know, and shows himself, so to speak, man, The elect of the nation of Israel, Lord willing, that's us brothers, and I speak going towards, you know, the sincere brothers out there teaching the truth. First and foremost, you know what I'm saying? We're going to be changed, you know? Yahweh Bashim Yahshua is going to endow us with that spiritual power, you know what I mean? Hey, man, you know what I mean?
And we speak boldly about that, too.
Yeah.
We speak boldly about that, too, because... you know, when you get this truth, when it comes into you, you know, you get that perfect remembrance, and you really think back about in your you know, before you came into the truth, you know, you recognize certain truth, like, you know, some brothers was in conspiracies. I know I was into conspiracies. I read a lot of books about conspiracies and stuff like that. You get that perfect remembrance, but we speak boldly about a spiritual power, right, about not dying, you know what I'm saying, and seeing and seeing Yahweh Shai come back and not experiencing death, and Lord willing, we are part of the elect. You know, we say that because in reality, you know what I'm saying, we've actually thought about these things before coming into the truth. So we say those things boldly, you know. But I got another scripture right here. It's Philippians 1 and 21. It says, for to me to live is Yahweh Shai, and to die is gain.
That's right.
But if I live in the flesh, this is the fruit of my labor, yet while I choose, I want not. You know, so because if you live in the flesh, man, you know, scripture say when you do sin, you know what I'm saying, then comes death. You know what I'm saying? So that's the fruit. That'll be the fruit of the labor of someone who lives in the flesh. But we walk according to the Spirit, you know what I mean? And we say, and we say that, you know, Lord willing, we're part of the elect, you know what I'm saying? Because we really don't know, but we have these, these are our inner thoughts. We yearn for salvation, and we're sincere, and we try to do, you know, and live to the best that we can, because we know that Yahweh Shai is not playing, you know what I mean? He's coming back for only a real small remnant, you know what I mean? And nobody can hide their deeds in that day, man. The Lord knows, man. The Lord knows who's are His, you know, and who's are not. So, you know, we don't fool anybody, you know what I'm saying? So,
Salaki, if I can say this, if I can add on what the brother's saying, because Yahweh Bashim Yashai, what do you say? He said when he comes back, he's going to reward everybody according to their works, whether they be good or whether they be bad.
Yeah.
And Lord willing, man, like I said, I speak for brothers out there first, man. You know, Lord willing, we're doing what's right through the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yashai. And Lord willing, our deeds are good. You know, Lord willing, man. Lord willing, the Heavenly Father deems us worthy for salvation. You know? Lord willing, you know?
Yeah. And going on, it says, for I am in strait betwixt two, having a desire to depart and to be with Yahweh Shai, which is far better. You know, so, you know, Paul was talking about, he wanted to be here to continue to do the ministry on earth, you know what I mean? But at the same time, you know, because Paul suffered many things, you know, for the gospel, you know what I'm saying? And just like we, the scripture also says, I want to say Matthew, but it says, basically, it's just one verse. It says, you know, something like, roughly paraphrasing, if you follow me, you're going to suffer, you know what I'm saying? So Paul was in the betwixt too. He was in the middle of suffering in this life for teaching the gospel and going out there and being amid a mockery and dying. He was like, you know, hey, I want to stay and I want to teach, you know what I mean? But on the second hand, you know, I just want to get beamed up out of here, you know what I'm saying? Beam me up, Scotty.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? And I know brothers feel like that, you know what I mean? I know the Akim feel like that, you know what I mean? Because, you know, we're going out there on the highway and highways and hedges, you know what I mean, to relay this message that was given to us. You know, every, you know, our portion, you know, my portion, I go out, you know what I mean, and I tell those that will receive it, because, you know, it's the gospel's a beautiful thing. And I know all the brothers have that same understanding, and they want others to understand it. That's why we go hard for the truth. So we're in the betwixt of the two, just like how Paul said it, to be here and teach, you know what I mean, and be around the Akim like that and get in contact with other Akim and be like-minded, you know what I'm saying, and shine off one another, man, and sharpen one another up, you know what I mean? Scriptures say what? Steel sharpens up steel, you know what I'm saying? So that's what we try to do, you know, but in the midst of that too, you know, in our daily personal lives, you know, when this brother's on his own or when I'm on my own, you know, so, you know, sometimes brothers just want to get up out of here, man. They want to see the chariots, you know what I mean? And we pray, and we ask the Most High, you know, let that will be done.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And do what you got to do, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, we pray, Lord, we're part of the elect. But if we're not, well, then it is what it is. You got to keep going. You got to keep going in this truth. And like Paul said, you know, it's like...
That's why the Lord said, give diligence to make your calling of election sure. So, you know, we're supposed to give that diligence, you know, that sincerity and that diligence of the searching of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai and his oracles. We're supposed to give that, you know, and if we die in Yahweh Shai, like the brother said, you know, the scriptures say, you know, we're going to rise first, you know, if we die in Yahweh Shai, you know, and death, man, when you get taken up to the spiritual realm, death. And that's another reason why Paul was saying that too, because he ain't gonna go through no more hell.
Yeah.
He gonna be with Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shine. He not gonna suffer no more. No? Cause what did Solomon say? He said, and below, hold, I look under the sun, the place of judgment. That's all the earth is. When we come down here, the earth is what? A place of judgment. Cause when you might have something that you have done in your past life, and you died in that life, and you went up to the Heavenly Father, and you waited that third or fourth generation to come back, and you'll pay for that on what? When you come back to the earth. So that's why Solomon said he's seen under the sun, the place of judgment. It was talking about the earth, all right? Because when you come back, you get judged for that past act, you know? And Lord willing, man, Yahweh Bashim Yashak blot us brothers' sins out, man. Because if he didn't go on that cross, you know, if he didn't suffer the things that he suffered, ain't would none of us make it. not even the remnant. The people that he died was for the elect. That's why in if you can get me John 17:9, that's why the Lord said this. The Lord actually prayed for his brothers, the elect. All right? And that's the same thing we got to do for brothers out here too. Come. Following the footsteps of Yahweh Bashim Yashai, pray for the Akim.
Yeah.
I do. You know? I pray for all the sincere brothers out there teaching the word of truth and sincerity.
Come. Hey, you know what? I was reading a scripture the day. You know, it escapes me, but it says, Paul says, he says something to the effect of, like I'd be sinning if I didn't pray for the brothers. You know what I'm saying? But this is John 17:9. It says, I pray for them. I pray not for the world.
Yeah, the them in that scripture is talking about the elect. All right? That's the them that it's talking about. That's who Yahweh Shai prayed for. All right?
But for them which thou hast given me.
But for them which thou hast given me. Because the scripture said what? In John 16:15, ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you. The only ones that was given to Yahweh Shai was what? The elect. Right? And he said what? Ain't nobody going to be able to pluck them out of my Father's hand, or my hand, man. So the elect is going to abound in the truth no matter what, you know? Like I said, Lord willing, we are the elect. Because honestly, if we got to say that, and Yahweh Bashim Yashai so bad, he did it that way that the elect aren't going to know they are the elect. Because say if certain brothers knew that they were the elect, that gives room for them to be proud. And they wouldn't come out here and teach because they knew that they were going to be what? Saved. But we're trying to make that calling of election sure, and it's a humbling thing to say, I don't know, because we don't know. Ain't none of it, don't none of us got a chariot ticket in our hands right now. You know what I mean? Don't none of us. So for dudes that think they do, it's all bad, man. It's all bad, man. We ain't in the chariots yet. You know what I'm saying? We don't have spiritual power yet. All we have is the diligence, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding that Yahweh Bashim Yashai gave us to go out there and teach his word and finish the work. That's it. Other than that, man, we don't got no power right now. You know?
It says,
oh, that was it.
For they are thine. Con. I gotta first. Let's see.
But yeah, you know, hey. You know, and that proud shit, man, all that proud shit, that gotta. And I get the own beam out of my eye first before I talk about anybody else. So don't even get that to it. That proud shit gotta go out the window. You know, Yahweh Bashim Yashai gave certain brothers certain instructions and certain wisdom and certain examples, you know what I'm saying, and experience to go through certain stuff so that certain brothers don't go through it themselves. You know? It's not a bad thing to listen to people that's been in this truth for a while. And that's what you gotta look at. You know, the experience of things, all right? Them men, you know what I'm saying? Certain men have been in this truth for a while, so they know certain things, and they tell younger brothers not to do certain things, so they don't go through it. That's called a dodged bullet, you yeah. know what I'm saying? Like, it's like you dodging a bullet. You seen the shit coming, and you dodged it. You know what I'm saying? Like the Matrix, when they dodge them bullets, and you see them slow motion.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, that's just what it is. You know what I'm saying? A wise man heareth instruction, you know?
Yeah. Con, it got a precept right here. It's 1 Thessalonians 4:14. It says, for if we believe that Yahweh Shai died and rose again, even so them also would sleep in Yahweh Shai will the Most High bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of the Most High, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Okay? So, you know, so it says, you know, those that believe that Yahweh Shai died on the cross and follow Yahweh Shai in the truth, what is it the scripture say? In the spirit and truth, you know what I mean? The Lord's going to take them with him, you know what I'm saying? And Lord willing, And even those that die in Yahweh Shai, they're not gonna be, you know, they're gonna get it first. They're gonna get, you know what I'm saying, beamed up first. They're gonna be the ones, man, because they died for Yahweh Shai. You know what I'm saying? So even how much more those that don't die, you know what I'm saying, they're not gonna be better than those who did die. You know what I'm saying? As a matter of fact, You know, they're like, they're kind of like, it's kind of like superior, man, because they're going to be resurrected first, man. And they're going to be, for sure, get those spiritual powers, because Yahweh Bashim Yashai, he's that, his promise is that great that like, you died for me. I mean, you know, you actually rode for me. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people say they're going to ride, and you know what I'm saying? When it really comes down to it, they don't ride. You know what I mean? They're over there slandering, talking, you know what I'm saying, this and this and that. But, you know, in reality, you got to have your brain about this. And if you fall, you know what I'm saying, get back up, because, you know, the Lord's looking for riders. You know, we're going to ride to the end through this truth, man. And if it means death, man, you know what? So be it, man. So be it. You know what I'm saying? If we got to get taken out, you know, it's, hey, man.
And Lord willing, the Lord give us the spirit to be able to bear it. No?
Gone. You know, because you know, there's gonna be people that you know, they're this and they're whoopty wop, and you know what I'm saying. But in the end, you know, they're gonna take the chip, or they're gonna take the back route. They're not gonna be able to make it. You know what I'm saying? So that's another thing that should be humbling to people. You know what I mean? To brothers, you know what I'm saying? Because it goes to every brother's mind. You know what I mean? And Lord willing, the Lord give us that spirit to endure if we were to have to die. You know.
That's right.
But it says 16, 1 Thessalonians 4:16. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of the Most High, and the dead in Yahushua shall rise first. So like I was saying, you know, the dead, those that die, you know, they're going to rise first. All right. It says, it says 17. It says, then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Okay, so you know, it says, so those that are alive, they're gonna meet those, you know, in the air, you know, with the Lord. You know what I'm saying? So
like the brother said, man, you know what I'm saying, the ones that die first, they already got their ticket. They with Yahweh Bashim Yahushua, you know, like they're gonna ride in. The scriptures say, you know, those that sleep. So the brothers ain't, you know, like Yahweh Shine, when he did what? When they said this person is dead, he said, he's not dead, man, he's just sleeping.
Yeah, let's get that. What is that? That's
I forgot what the exact account was.
That's, you know, Lazarus, isn't it?
Nah, it was when Yahweh Shine made somebody, he basically woke somebody up, so called, from the dead, you know what I mean? He said, what? He said, yo, look, man, he's not sleeping. He's just, he's not dead. He's just asleep. We told him to get up, and he what? He got up, man, because Yahweh Shine had what? Spiritual power. Stuff like that, too, man, is going to start happening out here. Lord willing, because we're in the time of Acts all over again. And Yahweh Bashim Yahushua said, what? Ye shall receive power after the Holy Spirit hath come upon you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, Khan. So, that's the first chapter.
Khan. So the Yahweh Bashim Yahushua already gave us the Holy Spirit, and that's what? The spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahushua, the scripts, man. He gave us the Holy Spirit, the truth. You know what I mean? So after that comes what? Power. You know? Then the power, you know, we waiting for it. Because we still going to have brothers out here healing people, you know, making people whole again. When I say whole, for simpletons out there, I mean, if somebody has doesn't have a whole arm, you know, you'll be able to make his whole arm, you'll be able to make his body full again. You know what I'm saying? We, you know, Yahweh Bashim Yahushua is gonna have stuff. We're not only gonna be killing the brother always brings it out. You're not only gonna be killing out here, we're gonna be healing, you know, making people that are blind to see, making people that are deaf to hear.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Yahweh Bashim Yahushua is going to bless us with power like that. You know what I'm saying? So, you know what I mean? Like, hey, man, Yahweh Bashim Yahushua is bad, man.
Yeah.
There's certain people on this earth that are deaf and blind for a reason. So the Heavenly Father can show his power through us. And we're not going to be like, oh, yeah, I did that. No, we're going to be like, hey, through the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahushua, you know, see again. You know, stuff like that, you know, here again.
If I may say something, you know what? Two scriptures come to mind. You know, one of them it was where there's a scripture that says that many people shall say in that day. It says, Lord, we healed people, we casted out demons and devils. He will say, get away from me, you workers of iniquity. But when you really look at it, you know what I'm saying? When we're out there in the highways and the hedges, and you bring somebody into the fold, hey, you really are casting out demons, man.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
You're spiritually casting out demons, man. You know, so yeah, and you, yeah, that's right. You're healing them. So you know, that's another thing. Is spiritually, you know, brothers got to look into. You know, when you're out there, make, you know what I'm saying, reach for the elect, man. Reach for the fold. Reach to get, you know. And when you see somebody this is their ears pricked up like that, man. Hey, man. You know what I'm saying? Couldn't be part of the elect. Reach out to that man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Like I got a brother. I call him a brother now. You know, at the job. The spirit had me telling the truth. I work construction. This brother does too, you know. And we get a lot of basically time to where we're not really being supervised. So Yahabashi Me'asha had it to where this Gadite man at the job, you know what I'm saying? He said it before I even came up to him, not boasting myself. But he was like, man, you had, you know, a type of aura around you, like you knew something, man. He was like, you kind of glowing, man. And I was like, well, hey, that's Yahabashi Me'asha. And I told him the truth. You know, and he believed me. He's coming into it little by little. If you could give me Isaiah 28.
Yeah. I also wanted to say real quick, you know, the other scripture that I was talking about, it says, if anybody have an infirmity, you know what I'm saying, call the elders and anoint his head and pray for him, because the fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much, man. So, you know, that's another thing that you know, we want to throw up in there, is that, you know what I mean, of that spiritual aspect, you know, spiritual power, not be scared of death, you know what I mean, and we have powers like that with faith and to heal people, you know what I mean. So you know, if you see somebody sick, you got a family member, your wife or one of your children is sick like that, you know, anoint their head and pray over them, man, and have faith, man, and you know, we're supposed to be able to heal them. And you need to believe that, you know what I'm saying? So, because, you know, being righteous, you know, fervent prayer, it availeth much. We're supposed to look into these things. We're supposed to know these things and hold fast to these things. Would you say Isaiah?
Isaiah 28, I think it's 10. Yeah, if possible, I think 9.
28 and 9?
Yeah. Because, yeah, hey, like the brother said, that's why the scriptures say what? We're supposed to stay in all prayer and supplications. We're supposed to pray for brothers, man. You're supposed to, you know what I mean, let brotherly love continue. You know, you should pray for a brother. If he ain't got a percentage of the knowledge, or he's going off, you know what I'm saying? I don't got to be by that, man. But, hey, Yahabashi Me'asha willing, man. You know what I'm saying? That brother will come out of that madness. You're supposed to pray for brothers, too. And if he don't, well, shit, it just wasn't for him. I can't do nothing about that. I'm not Yahabashi Me'asha. You know what I'm saying? I'm not the Most High. It's the Most High's will. The scriptures say, let thy will be done. You know what I'm saying? Not our will. You know?
You said...
babes.
Okay. It says, Isaiah 28:9, whom shall he teach knowledge?
Whom shall he teach knowledge, man? Who shall Yahabashi Me'asha teach knowledge? Go ahead.
And whom shall he make to understand doctrine?
That's right.
Them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breasts.
Yeah, because like I was going into, what do Yahushua say, man? You're supposed to convert yourself as a little child. You know what I mean? Like, what does a baby do? It drinks milk. You know what I mean? And like I was saying, you know, through the spirit of Yahushua, the Gadite at my job, you know, the Heavenly Father blessed brothers with that milk to give him. You know what I'm saying? And he's slowly coming into it. You know, he's slowly, little by little, coming into it, because the scriptures say this, the race isn't given to the swift. You know, this thing is a process. It's not, and then that's it. Man, you gotta take the baby steps, and even him himself, he's slowly coming out of stuff. He's asking brothers, Shalawamin brothers, you know, he got the name now. You know what I'm saying? He's Shalawamin brothers, you know what I'm saying? Saluting brothers, you know what I mean? Like, that's a beautiful thing.
It is.
He's getting it little by little. You know, just even like myself, you know what I'm saying? When I first came in, I got it bit by bit, here and there, you know, a little. And then Yahabashi Me'asha fully brought me into it. You know what I'm saying? So, like the scripture say, man, a race ain't given to the swift, man.
Yeah.
All right? Fast-paced people, it's not given to the swift. You know, Yahabashi Me'asha is going to give you the milk, and then you'll be able to get that meat, you know?
It says Isaiah 28:9, whom shall he teach knowledge, and shall help you make to understand doctrine, them that are weaned from the milk and drawn from the breasts.
Yep, because this truth is referred to as what? Food, you know? Honey, bread, milk, wine, meat. The scriptures always refer to truth to as a type of food. Did you have some? Can I get Proverbs the 9th chapter? You know, in food, what do you do with food? You eat it upon a table, you know?
Proverbs 9?
Yeah.
From the top?
Yeah.
It's Proverbs 9. Wisdom hath builded her house. She hath hewn out her 7 pillars. She hath killed her beast. She hath mingled her wine.
Yep, wine. You see that? The Most High is referring wisdom, knowledge, understanding of what? Wine. Go ahead.
She hath also furnished her table.
Furnished her table. Go ahead.
She hath sent forth her maidens. She crieth upon the highest places of the city.
When we on the street corners, you know what I mean? We throwing that food out. We putting the food upon the table. And Lord willing, you know, when we out on the street corners, you know, the elect of the nation Israel will see it and start eating it up. You know?
Come. That's right.
That's all we can hope for.
Right. Yep. You know what? 1 second. I was looking for a scripture.
Yeah, but in the book of Revelation, the 10th chapter, what did the angel tell John to do? He gave him the book and he told him what? Eat this book and it shall be sweet in thy mouth, but bitter in thy stomach. And the bitterness of the truth is the hell that we go through in society. You know? It's the hell we catch. The temptation, the hell, the everyday being tempted. You know what I'm saying? By these fuckheads at the job site. You know, every day you go to the store, somebody's fucking with you. You know what I'm saying? Or messing with you, so to speak. You know, hey, that's the bitterness of the truth.
Con.
You know?
I got a scripture, you know what I mean? Because me and the brother decided to come and make a video, you know what I'm saying? We didn't really prepare anything, no lessons. We just, you know what I'm saying, it's all through the spirit, you know what I mean? But you know, but one message that we wanted to convey was where's the sting in death? You know, roughly paraphrasing. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? But I got one more scripture right here. I don't forget anything else. We're gonna close it out after this. It's Galatians 6:14. It says, "But Most High forbid that I should glory, save in the cross of our Lord Yahweh Shai, by whom the world is crucified unto me, and I unto the world." Okay? So, you know, we don't glory in nothing but the cross, which is, you know, the resurrection, you know, Yahweh Shai dying for our sins, you know what I mean? He nailed all the sins to the cross, man. And Colossians, I think it's the 2nd chapter, that's a whole chapter right there. But, you know, so we don't glory in anything but that, you know what I mean? And we offer up our life as a living sacrifice. And you know, exactly like the world is dead to us, man, we're dead to the world.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And if you want
to... I was going to say on that, we're going to end it on this, man. You know, and us brothers out here, you know, we bearing up the cross like Yahweh Shai said. He said, take, you know, I think it's Luke the 9th chapter. But, no, you don't got to get it, brother. But, you know, I think it's Luke the 9th chapter. But he said, you know, if you follow me, take up your cross. And what does that cross represent? The things that he was going to suffer. You know, so just because, you know, and I'm saying this to younger brothers even coming in, just because it may not seem as though brothers is going through stuff, we're constantly being tested every day, every hour, man. Even in certain dreams in your sleep, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I say that because I have demons jump on me in dreams, man, and try to further, because that word demon basically means to take away your faith, man. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, you're going to have that, but you still, you know, you pray to Yahweh Bashim HaShem when you get up. You know what I'm saying? Ask him for more faith. We in the time, man. This is the time, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The end is close. You've seen it before your eyes. It's real close. So we in a time where brothers got to pray more. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Be more spiritual.
Spiritual.
You know what I'm saying? First and foremost.
Yeah, spiritual.
Keep spiritual, man, in all things, man. All right, keep that faith in Yahweh Bashim Yashak, because this thing is all, this society is almost a wrap. We just waiting it out. Things is gonna, it's all downhill for America from here. It's not going back up.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's not going back up. So, you know, with that being said, and if you have anything else to say, I'm gonna say, hey, Barakatai Yahweh Shai, man. You know, double honors to the apostles of GMS.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? That rule well. And Barakatai to your brothers out there that's teaching this word in truth and sincerity. And death to America, and death to so-called white people, and death to you heathens, and death to two-thirds of the nation of Israel that don't want to get this truth, or that's not meant to get it. You know? Shalom.
Shalom.